All right, yeah, John Lansky was just here talking about the 10-year sliding mortgage rates collapsing, and now we're seeing a lot of people taking advantage of this before any of this was actually happening, and now that it is, what to make of single people buying homes. John, what do you think?
I think it's a great idea. I mean, we have these very low mortgage yields. Why not go ahead and give it a shot? Rents have been going higher, and of course, this rent inflation makes home ownership all the more attractive. But of course, you have to be in a region where housing is affordable, and that's not necessarily the case in New York City nor in places like San Francisco.
But we are seeing more young people than ever doing that too.
Yeah, and I think we're forgetting that the millennials, which are arguably the fastest growing, most diverse generation ever, are older. Millennials are like in their late 30s, early 40s. So that's who is going into the market. A lot of them are diverse. You know, me being Hispanic, of course, I'm going to throw that fact. In the next 10 years, 56% of new homeowners will be Hispanic.
Is that right?
Yeah, because we're getting more educated. It's an upwardly mobile community. And we're seeing, you know, low unemployment, high entrepreneurship. It's a good combination and fast growth rates in terms of population size. So that is, it gives me hope for a healthy economy ahead.
And, you know, the wind is at their back when it comes to the home price situation, notwithstanding in some markets, certainly what's happening on the rate front, right? Mm-hmm.
The rates are great. I think there's an issue of what is driving the lack of affordability. And in a lot of places, people have talked about California, it's very difficult to build. It's expensive to build and to own homes. And so I think this is a good issue for all of those politicians who want to speak to young people and talk about how do you get into your first home? How do you start that American dream? And there are lots of things that can be done as far as making it easier to build. We see there's a story in our paper today about an operator of trailer parks who's been crushing it for the last 10 years, and it's driven by the difficulty of developing new ones and the fact that home prices are so expensive that people are looking for a better option. So there's a lot to be done here in terms of looking at why do we have this affordability problem?
Or we can force the issue. I know in California, the governor there, Newsom, is saying that doctors should be able to write prescriptions for housing.
Mm-hmm.
What do you make of that?
That's ridiculous. Come on,
okay, tell me how you feel.
You know, I mean, a lot of these poor people that are homeless really can't function on their own. For, you know, in many cases, they're mentally ill. They have all the drug problems, alcohol problems. Is this going to solve anything? I don't think so. And again, people don't want
the alternative. I think he's saying is they're out on the street and all of that. But
yeah, even if you had special housing for the homeless, many people wouldn't be crazy about having that in their neighborhood. A lot of these people in years ago, they were what? They were institutionalized. We don't have that anymore, so they're out on the streets.
Yeah. I have a perspective on that maybe disagrees a bit with that John, who I respect dearly. You know, 80% of health outcomes are related to other things that are not treatment or access to medical care. 20% is access to medical care. This is World Health Organization. The social determinants of health are what drives an ultimate good outcome. Now, it may not be just housing, it's other things, education, the access to nutritious foods, etc. 88% of our healthcare spending goes to the 20% of medical care and treatment. So something is wrong with that formula. I mean, I work with a lot of big pharma companies and payers that are looking to a new way of delivering care that is comprehensive. I'm not saying it's just this housing solution, but it made me think broader of social determinants of health are a thing that need to be into our mix of solutions. It may not be just be housing, but there's a different way of looking at this because we're spending too much money bad outcomes.
I'm hoping California will just stop intervening in the housing market. If they want to roll back some regulations, that's great, but this is the largest, by far the largest unsheltered homeless population in the United States. A lot of policies in California to blame, I think, in terms of both on the health side, the housing side, but a retreat by government, I think, is what's most needed there.
Costs money, too.
You know, if I don't have a job, maybe I'm going to go to an area, lower cost of living, where there are employment opportunities. Some people, again, can't make the choice. But for many of these people you're talking about, there's such a thing as self-responsibility.
Exactly.
You've got to take care of yourself, okay? You can't depend on the government or somebody else. You have to make up your mind that I'm tired of living this way, treating myself badly, and just change the environment that you're in. so that you could go ahead and move forward.
Yeah. All right. Well put. Final word on the subject. I want to thank you all very, very much. And everyone's just got to calm down. I mean, I know we're talking about a Dow that is now closing on a 600-point loss on top of a 1,000-point loss yesterday. But we have been through worse. I'm not talking markets. I'm talking World War II. I'm talking the whole concept of a democratic republic at Dow. That was not that long ago. Martha McCallum spells it out in a beautiful new book that connects her family to that history right after this.